Hi everyone, it's Allyssa from the Township of Washington Library, and for today's Teen and Adult Craft Day In, we are going to be turning this very cheap, very plastic tray into this, our very own custom chalkboard tray, which you can use for decoration or even as like a cheese platter, and you can label all of your cheeses or meats or something like that. This is really great because chalkboard paint is actually quite expensive for a little jar. We are using today your own regular paint. Latex or acrylic work really well for this, and we're using plaster of Paris. So it's a lot cheaper than chalkboard paint, and it is a lot more readily available. The plaster of Paris for a gigantic tub was only a couple of bucks, and paint you can find just about anywhere. The nice thing about this also is, even though I chose to be pretty boring and do black and white, the chalkboard paint that you can buy at the store typically only comes in a very small range of colors. You could get black, you can get green, typical chalkboard colors, and sometimes you can get blue, but not usually. So if you're making it homemade with your own paint and your own plaster of Paris, you can do any color that you want. So is your room yellow? Is your room purple? Is your room green? Is it brown? Is it a certain shade of red? You can make a chalkboard that matches that. You can also go ahead and use this recipe to make a larger chalkboard. You can turn anything into a chalkboard. It is super trendy right now, and you can go ahead and chalkboard your entire house. Have fun with that. So I'm going to show you in just a few easy steps how to turn this tray from basic to awesome. Okay, so my tray here has been taped out with painter's tape, and I have my cup of plaster of Paris. And I mixed it with a little bit of water. You don't need that much water. You want it to be a paste, but not super thick, if you can see the consistency here. It's not super thick, but it's not really runny. And I mixed that with my black paint. So they say the recipe is like 3 parts paint to 2 parts plaster of Paris to 1 part water. I kind of winged it. We're going to see what happens. So I'm going to do a traditional chalkboard. I have my black paint, so I'm going to start painting this, and we'll see what happens as it dries. As you can see, this is super, super streaky, and some of that has to do with this nice, lovely, slick plastic surface. So I'm in a pretty well ventilated area. The air is on. This is acrylic paint. It dries pretty quickly. I believe you can use acrylic or latex paint, and both of those will dry pretty nicely on a surface like this. So I'm gonna let this dry for just a couple of minutes, and then I'm gonna go over it again with another coat. I might need a third coat, I'm not really sure, so we'll see what happens. But definitely you need more than one coat, and you should let it dry in between coats, otherwise you're just going to continue scraping and scraping and scraping lines with your brush. While I'm waiting for my second coat to dry, I'm gonna start at least painting outside. I guess I'm going for a little bit of a classic look. I picked a white, but I also added just a drop of tan to it. So it's kind of a creamy off-white, so it's not so stark. So I'm just gonna start painting the outside while I'm waiting. everyone. It is super humid in here, so I've been waiting for a while for my chalkboard tray to dry, and I am putting a final coat on some of the creamy color. It's definitely taking a while to dry. Our building is particularly humid right now, but that is all right. But our chalkboard portion is almost dry, so I think I can show you how to condition it so that you can actually turn it into a chalkboard. Before you just start writing on the chalkboard with a piece of chalk, you need to condition your chalkboard. And this goes for pretty much any chalkboard paint that you buy, whether it's commercial or homemade. You have to basically, you prep it by rubbing chalk on it, and then you wipe it off. All right, so that's getting better. Definitely is taking a couple of coats for the white to take, just like for the black. And again, I did put a little bit of the plaster of Paris in the white paint as well, so it had more of a matte finish as well. It, kind of like that chalk paint that's not a chalkboard, but it's got a particular finish to it, which is really nice, and I think it goes well with the kind of rustic chic design. So here's what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring this down a little bit. So I'm going to take my chalk and I'm going to long ways. I'm not going to do it on the whole thing. As you can see, there are still some wet patches, but I'm just going to show you right here. So like that's a big wet patch and that's wet over there. But I'm just going to show you a little bit. You do the chalk long ways and you rub it all over your surface. And then you take a damp paper towel and then you just rub away the extra chalk dust, and that helps to condition and prep your board for writing messages. And now I have a chalk tray. If you don't condition it first, you will find that when you go to erase your words, you're gonna have a weird ghost print, and it's not going to erase entirely. But now mine is a lot easier to erase. And again, you can keep using a wet paper towel. And it's durable, just like a real chalkboard surface. It's pretty cool. So it does take a while to dry. The Plaster of Paris box says it takes about 20 to 30 minutes for the Plaster of Paris itself to set. You need to wait for the paint to dry. You need to deal with the humidity. Acrylic paint itself dries pretty quickly. So it just depends on a couple of factors, but you will notice it will turn lighter when it dries, and that means that it's ready. I would just give it a full 24 hours if I were you. But otherwise, this is really cool. And this is just a dollar store tray. So you can do this to just about anything, and you can remake things and decorate them to match your own decor. And I think this is a pretty cool one. You can hang this up on your wall. You can use it as a platter with some food, some cheese, some fruit, whatever. You can use this as a menu board in your kitchen. You could use it to write notes to your family. Hang this up in your room, do your to-do list, your homework, your meal plan for the week. Don't forget about a concert or an event or something that you need to do. Really cool. So I hope you all have fun with it. If you do this craft, please send me some pictures. You can comment below with your picture. You can email it to me, send us a Facebook message, or tag us on Instagram at TWP Wash Library. All right, everyone, that is it for me today. I will see you next time. Bye.